Now we're off to Northland and a region that was loved by Frederick Hundertwasser, the late Austrian-born artist and architect.
Nature was always front and centre as he created his wonderfully zany and colourful works of art, like his famous toilets in Kaikomako. Now a tribute to his genius is being erected in Whangarei, and the rarest of native plants will be making a major contribution. Here's Michael Holland.
They're as unique and intriguing as each other.
It couldn't be more special.
This unlikely coming together of our most endangered plant species,
threatened with extinction,
and the beautifully bizarre that is Hundertwasser.
It's not straight. I haven't found a straight line.
A unique plant on a unique building. Just amazing. Penantia baylisiana, more commonly known as kaikomako.
Kaikomako.
Kaikomako. One surviving tree in the wild. That's it. Doesn't get rarer. Just doesn't get rarer.
It's quite the tale.
It's a real tale, isn't it?
One that has its origins on the rugged Three Kings Islands, off the very tip of the country, where that one surviving tree remains. Trouble is, it's a she, without a mate.
No male. That's it. Hey. A lonely girl.
And therefore unable to reproduce.
So there may be no chance of it ever reproducing in the wild as such.
These 9 prized examples, grown by Guy Bowden and his wife Sandra for the rooftop forest on the new Hundertwasser Arts Centre, all having direct lineage to the lone female.
It's rugged, feel it, it's so leathery and tough.
Scientists having managed against the odds to propagate cuttings taken when they first discovered her back in the 1940s.
These guys stuck with it, and thank goodness. And look, you know, it's saved from extinction through their hard work and perseverance.
Why only one island survivor, you ask? Well, goats were introduced to the Three Kings in the late 1800s as a potential food source for shipwreck victims. Those same goats then helping themselves to all the vegetation their new home had to offer.
The goats just devoured them. Yes, goats do what goats do and ate everything in front of them, pretty much. You get this a wonderful recurving of the leaves that, yeah.
Recurving.
Recurving, so that's this curling up business that's happening here. And it's a way of protecting this rather more delicate underside from the harsh salt winds and sun.
It's going to be the largest deforested roof in the southern hemisphere, and it will evolve over time. It's like a forest, it's not regular. Visitors can walk through the forest, paths will develop naturally over time.
At last, we're here. We're doing it.
That is one crazy building.
Isn't it? It's like a lot of kids have got hold of it and drawn all over it. It's pretty cool.
And here come your babies.
Come the babies, yeah.
I'm thinking you're quite tickled.
I'm over the moon. See them rising up onto that building. Hey, cool. Very good. And people can see what beauty we have and what we could have lost. They're going to be standing proud there. You know, like, look at me. I'm one of the rarest trees in the world. Yeah.
Special.
Special, very special.
Beautiful, what a beautiful building and what a beautiful idea. The rooftop garden, love it. You just want to keep the goats away from those plants, don't
Definitely.
You?
Definitely, yeah, keep the goats away. It's a beautiful, beautiful building. I've been driving past it quite frequently and seeing the development there. It's going to be spectacular when it opens, and it will be completed towards the end of the year. It's just amazing.